is a famous landmark, Chaco Canyon. I encourage everyone to go and visit. And there's etchings of astronomical experiences that occurred, supernovas, that nobody else knew about. And it's recorded right here in New Mexico. Now, you roll the clock forward quite a few years in our space history, and some was mentioned on, but I want to reiterate that. The bravery and the innovation and the leadership that it took to enable John F. Kennedy's vision to get to the moon, that pre-space work was done right here just over those mountains. So, yes, we had von Braun and the V-2s, but we also had Colonel Paul Stapp. Colonel Paul Stapp, and you all have videos, hopefully, that's going to commemorate the wonders of New Mexico and that space history, and that's a brand new video that just rolled out, and we had to special order those to get them done. Michael Lennick, Foolish Earthling Productions, created that with Jerry Johnson over in Alamogordo, so thank you for that wonderful documentary that documents the history of New Mexico and the value of why New Mexico is first in these areas. But Colonel Paul Stapp, you talk about a guy, why do we have seat belts today? It's largely due to Colonel Paul Stapp and the work he did on the sled track, which is still in operation today, doing very important test work. That's another asset we have here in New Mexico. Spaceport America is not just about this location. It is about the collective of New Mexico, Sandia, Los Alamos Labs, the universities. We've got White Sands Missile Range, Holloman Air Force Base. We've got the Very Large Array. We've got our Sunspot and Apache Observatories over in the Cloudcroft area. This area is rich in capability, and that's what can bring these companies here to do their research, their development, and certainly Spaceport America adds this new commercial asset, not only for the kids, which is at the core, education. You know, the United States of America having a commercial that's out there promoting that we're 21st in math and 25th in science or vice versa, that's not to be tolerated. We will become number one in math, science, technology, and engineering. May 2nd, we had that historic launch. That's the importance, to give our kids what they need, those tools to do applied learning, workforce development, right while they're in the classroom. Don't just give them the book work. Convert that to actual knowledge and hands-on experience. That creates retention rates in our youth here in New Mexico and will encourage others to come here and participate in those programs. Is going to be significant for mankind. So when we look at Colonel Paul, what did he do? That person, he wouldn't let anybody else ride it, and I'm not sure if it was that much fun or whether he really thought about safety and didn't want to hurt anybody else. But he would strap himself to a pack of rockets, and he would mortar down that racetrack. He put 47 Gs upon his bodies to see and validate that the forces the astronauts were going to experience would be able to take it, designing the restraint systems that would be required to enable us to go to the moon and beyond. So that individual, and he'd park an ambulance in his Cadillac at the end of that sled track, and he'd say, I'm going home in one of them. So it's people like this. That's the spirit. That's the bravery that we heard about in our national anthem. Those folks that knew that the sacrifice was worth it because we had to get that knowledge to be able to carry the torch forward into what could become the future. So you roll the clock forward again, and you've got Captain Joe Kittinger, turned 90 years old last year. A true hero, also highly recognized in the films. But Captain Joe Kittinger, you know what he did? He stepped on a gondola and took a high-altitude balloon ride. You know, now this is 1960. He hopped in this gondola and went up and up and over 100,000 feet. He was into the blackness of space. And what did he do? He jumped. He jumped hoping that technology those folks designed, because how do you test things like that? That parachute technology to bring it down and make it possible had to be created. And he jumped, and he is a man who went supersonic without an airplane. And so he has many records, and what a great individual. And on the way up, his pressure suit failed. Not the smartest thing to probably do, but he knew if he called it out, they'd scrub the mission. But he knew the value of this mission and what it meant to the space program, and knew that the program may very well be canceled if that happened. So he went on up. And he came down, and still living today as our hero, a hero of New Mexico who led us to the next stage. So it's time to move on with the program. I could go on. I'm very passionate about this subject, obviously. But Spaceport America is the gateway to the future, the gateway to the future of space, science, technology, new medicines, and beyond that we can only dream about. And we encourage the great companies to come here and do this wonderful work. For we, as Spaceport America, are enabling this infrastructure. And we welcome all to come here from around the world to experience what New Mexico has, the capabilities we have throughout New Mexico, to do their wonderful work and propel us to the next level. Thank you.
Governor, would you like to come up here? Are you ready to break new ground?
We are ready.
Okay, you guys just thought you were done with me. Not quite yet. Spaceport America has, as I said, it doesn't just happen, and there's a group of organizations and individuals that have made this possible. And so these are our Rocketeers that we celebrate here today. And these are the organizations that, for without their support, we would not be here today. So we want to recognize, obviously, from the great state of New Mexico, the Honorable Bill Richardson. We have our anchor tenant and partner, Virgin Galactic, Will Whitehorn. And from the FAA, Associate Administrator, Dr. George Neal. Representing the New Mexico Spaceport Authority, Daniela Glick. Now, our special partner, White Sands Missile Range. Today, standing in for Brigadier General David L. Mann is new Executive Director Robert Carter. We have Chairman of Spaceport America, Spaceport Tax District, Walter Armijo. And the land upon which we are sitting, for this would not be possible without the Bar Cross and Lewis Kane Ranches. And so we have with us a very special individual, Mrs. Jane Kane. And along with Jane is Judy Wallen. And we thank them for their coexistence of the spaceport, where the cattle will roam and Spaceport Miracle will participate right next to the history of the Wild West. We have Sierra County Chairman of the County Commission, Mr. James Coslin. And from New Mexico State University, obviously an awesome partner for us. Standing in for President Pacheco is Vice President Ben Woods. And we have from Doniana County Commission, not here.